Imagine Hitchcock's Strangers on a Train, but with women instead of men. Jacqueline Bissett and Teresa Russell are plotting murder tonight at 9 on 5.
My friend Babs.
Oh, my friend Babs.
And you know, it's
lovely.
This is our last show before we take our summer break. You're all supposed to go. But let's face it, could we have a better guest than Babs Windsor to end on?
I'm very privileged to be here. I've just done a stint, a lunchtime stint at the Vic.
Are you good at lunchtime stints?
I'm very good, you know. And they all send their love to you.
I tell you what, this is like the blonde show today. Man, I'm real. Mine's real.
Aren't I?
Yeah.
And don't we have more fun?
Listen, we do.
Yes,
I tell you
we
what,
do.
I haven't seen my colour since I was 17. My proper colour.
Same as me. I don't even remember 17. I mean, goodness me, 17.
I want to tell you that apart from Babs, we've got just a great star lineup. We've also got David Soul.
Oh! Yes! Yes, and I'm happy to say that I know the gentleman quite well.
Did you fancy him when he was in
always? Oh, it was always him, the blonde one.
He was the one for you.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, wasn't he?
I hate to tell you, he's got his girlfriend with him today.
Has he?
And his son.
Has he brought the dog?
He's brought the dog.
Yes,
Jackie. And lovely, he's got his best friend, whom I know you know, Stefan Dennis.
Oh, he's lovely.
Yes, on from Ramsey. So, do you remember Stephanie was there for 7.5 years?
I can't
fantastic.
Wait.
So, it's a great lineup. It's a great show. But we're going to start off with Babs Windsor. Will we have a seat? For a while.
Long, forever and a day.
Forever and a day. But you know, the last couple of years have been phenomenal.
It's been wonderful.
But when
it?
I saw you at Buckingham Palace, those photographs of your MBE, how did you feel when you heard you got it?
Well, it's a funny, you get this letter from Downing Street to say that your name's been put forward to the Queen. And if you don't want it, you've got to let them know. But you know, I wasn't expecting it, really. I mean, you don't expect that. But once they write you and say, yes, we're thinking of giving it to you, you can't wait. And you could immediately, made me think of my mom, you know, how thrilled and how proud she'd be.
How do you think Rose would have reacted?
Oh, she would have loved it, because she always wanted me to be posh, my mum. Yeah, her daughter Babs, be posh. You know, and she sent me to elocution lessons, believe it or not. And the first job I got was in Bells of St. Trinian, you know, yelling out the window, ta-da, mum, see you next old. And she was appalled. She was a bit of a cockney snob, my mum, a good lady, but she wanted to better herself. That was it. So she would have been. And the fact is, you know, I've got the name of Windsor, because I changed my name when I was about 16. I was in a show called Love from Judy, and they said Deeks, which was my name, Barbara Deeks, wasn't a good stage name.
And, of course, in this case, it was Windsor to Windsor.
That's right. Uh-huh. I actually said that. I said, it was very nice talking to her. I said, you know, because I'm a Windsor as well, you see. But I took the name from my Auntie Dolly, and it was also the coronation. Year as well.
Nice.
So there was a
nice connection.
Yes,
there.
Yes, it was.
And the picture I loved best was when you were curtsying, showing you Shirley Bassey how to curtsy.
Well, I've known the great Miss Bassey forever and a day also. I mean, since I was about 1920.
Love this. Where was
it? Oh, and that's just outside. But you see, you know, that proper frock, you know, and I was so thrilled that she'd be made a dame. I mean, it was an automatic thing to do. You just go, madam, you know, like that. And of course, she fell about laughing. She shrieked. And it was good. And it just captured the imagination of the press, didn't it?
That's a great shot.
Yeah, it was lovely.
And you took Scott with you, presumably.
Oh, yeah, he was absolutely thrilled to bits. You know, we was running around trying to get him a shirt that would kind of match my outfit. You know, I said, you can't have blue or anything. It's got to have a little bit of peachy pink in it. We're doing all that on the Saturday before with all the sales. I didn't realise it was the sales. It was all a bit mental. It was lovely. My dear agent, Barry Burnett, you know Barry, he came with me. And it was a whole wonderful day. And they were so thrilled for you, the public. They're saying, bah, oh, terrific. Great air bar. It was the most wonderful experience.
And then, of course, it wasn't a strange day anyway. I mean, exciting day, because it was that huge celebration on Horse Guards Parade for the Queen Mum in the afternoon.
And I saw you, yes.
Well, there I was. I had a stiff neck. I really was suffering from my neck and couldn't turn.
Me and Norman Whistler were yelling at, Chloe, here we are. You had this posh frock on, didn't you?
Oh, yes, I'm walking along with, you know, trying to look like a very posh person. Yeah. And she's going, hey, Chloe.
This is this great parade for the wonderful Queen Mother that we were a part of. We were so thrilled, weren't we? That was a magnificent day, because I went from meeting one queen to another queen.
Of course.
And then in the evening, a couple of other queens.
Well, no, there you go. We'll not say who they were.
No.
And then, of course, the wedding this year. Now, the whole point is, because your life is so high profile with EastEnders and everything, how on earth did you manage to keep that a complete secret?
I don't know. I really don't know. And we made so many dates, and then I kept getting pulled into EastEnders. And then suddenly, out of nowhere, we went for, let's say, 2 weeks, made phone calls, booked with Dorchester, managed to book Marylebone, you know, the registry office, and it all fell into place.
And then you just released it the next day?
Yeah, well, I was coming to your birthday. Actually, nobody knew about it. But I phoned you up, didn't I? Because I didn't want to. It was Gloria's big birthday. We won't say what.
40, yeah? That's 40.
Yes.
I was.
And she'd invited, it was the day after I got married, and both Scott and I said, we can't take that away from Gloria. It's her day. So I phoned you up and said, no, we wouldn't be going, but we'll be thinking about your next thing, knock on the door, and it was lovely Steve, her old man, saying, Glo said you've got to come.
You're coming.
And I'm so glad we did, because we didn't have a party after the wedding. It was just me and Scott, which was wonderful, but we kind of celebrated it.
Yeah, I laid it on for you, basically.
Yes, you did. She paid for it all, for the reception. It was a bit like that, wasn't it? And it was glorious, and it was a masked ball. Wasn't it you?
Well, I thought when you hit that age of 40, you know, you either stick your head in the gas oven or you put a mask on. So I put a mask on. I thought it was a good idea.
Yeah, it was a great idea. We had a wonderful time. So thank you very much.
Not at all. Congratulations. Now, of course, Madame Tussauds, then, you created history because you're the first soap star, I think,
to
go in there.
Yeah, I just couldn't believe that. That's just amazing. And I thought it would be a few pictures. So I took along a few pictures and that's all. And it takes forever. They say strike a pose. So. And that's how we're going to be.
The photographers, they know the people.
But you see, I wouldn't have done that pose. I would have just done that had I known. So I did that. You've got to stare like that for 2 hours. And then you go on a wheel going round, and they measure you here and here. And it's amazing. And then with the eyes, you know, they've got to get it right.
Well, do you know that we had a sculptor from Madame Tussauds here in the house one day? I mean, it is an amazing likeness.
It's an amazing likeness.
But you know what he did? He brought in a box of eyeballs.
Oh, isn't it horrible? I know.
It's horrible. And it sort of goes like, which eyeball would you like?
Yes, that's right, that's it. Yeah.
Did they do that one to you?
Yeah, everything immaculate in my hands, they go in the plaster. But that's amazing, and they say it's very, very popular. I live near Madame Tussauds, and I was sitting outside a cafe the other day having a late night drink with Mr. Dale Winton, because he lives around the corner as well, and some people literally walked by and they went, we've just seen you in Madame Tussauds.
So it's a weird feeling when you go in and you see such a likeness.
Yeah. Oh, it is. Yes, and I'm with Naomi Campbell and Joanna Lumley.
Oh,
it's really lovely, but it's very lifelike. And the press guy said they'd never seen anything like it.
And did you give the dress, or did
Yes,
they?
I did.
Because
I'm a bit of a funny size, I thought, and I wanted it to be very bright, very me, you know, so I took it along. And my shoes, I only take 1.5 shoes.
What?
So I took,
One and a half?
Yeah!
No,
no, silly!
Let me see them. Well,
look, tiny little things. My toes only come to there.
So you must get great in the sales. You get great
bargains. I do. My posh shoes, I go to lovely Jimmy Choo. He makes me these boots, you know.
I don't think I've ever met anybody one and a half.
I know, it's silly. Little Lucy Benjamin, who plays Lisa, you know, in the East Enders, she's size 2s. See, so you there, have there are some of us around.
So you put a bit of cotton wool in hers and use hers sometimes?
We're always on the lookout for each other.
And then the other thing is, you're doing your autobiography at the moment.
Yes.
Now, I know that in a way you didn't really want to do an autobiography. So
no,
what happened?
I didn't. Well, you get the rumours of the unauthorised biographies, you know, and you just think, oh, I don't want someone taking my life and, you know, talking about it. I know about my life, so that's how I started it. And but what I wasn't prepared for, kind of, okay, yeah, that's been 9 months, a year, but we had a hiccup in EastEnders about last February when Mike was taken ill, Mike Reed, who plays Frank Butcher. So kind of 6 weeks I lost because I thought they were going to write me out because they wrote him out. I thought they were going to write me out, but they didn't. They said, we've kicked into his storyline. You're the only one who can take that storyline over. So I did, and I was acting a bit like, with all the cars and that. I didn't know what I was talking about. So that, and then suddenly EastEnders said, you're going on location for 2 weeks in Spain. We've just come back from Spain in Alicante doing a very important episode, which was Roberta Taylor, who's leaving, who plays Irene. So it was tinged with a bit of sadness, actually, because yes. She's going. Because we
did have a bit
friends.
Of a laugh on the set, oh, though,
well,
right
we
there.
Did. Well, we of course we did.
Away
you can't help
Spain
it. Away
in Spain for 2 weeks?
But you don't really want to be filming in Alicante in EastEnders, not really. I mean, the sun's blazing down and everybody's going off and having siestas, isn't it? Yeah.
And fiestas.
Yeah, and fiestas. Is that as well, but you can't help but have a laugh with on EastEnders. They are very, believe it or not, we do. They're great people, and of course Mike Reed's wonderful. Yeah. I'm devastated because he's leaving.
Well, we're going to talk about that later in the show. God. But just with this autobiography, I mean, I know that clearly you'll be doing more interviews, and hopefully you'll come and see us again.
Oh yeah,
that
would be lovely. Yeah.
But are you bearing your soul?
I am. I mean, I'm sure people think, oh God, we know a lot about her because I'm always making the press, you know. But there's a lot more. Yes, there is. An awful lot more. I've called it all of me, like a twat I am. I mean, fancy calling it all of me because I've really got to dig deep, and I have this time.
And is that a bit painful sometimes?
Yes, it is. It is. I do find a lot of times I'm crying as I'm writing, you know, but I think it's going to be a good book.
Well, you know, Barbara's going to be staying around because, you see, if this is the last programme for the holiday, I've got a bit of scrubbing and cleaning to do later on too. Will you give me a hand?
Yeah, I haven't got to do any cooking, though, have I?
No, no cooking, just cleaning today. But for the moment, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Babs Windsor. World-famous actor and now director on stage, that's David Soul, proves that theatre is the family business when he, along with his son Christopher, his partner in life, Alexa Hamilton, a gorgeous lady, his dog Checky, whom Barbara knows, and his very good friend, former Neighbours star, Stefan Dennis, join us live right here in this house, so stay with us.